Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Today our discussion point is effective and advanced communication skills. We know communication is a very important for personal, professional, as well as organizational success. Therefore, learning effective communication and advanced communication skills is very important for our day-to-day operation. Whether it is in business, it is in service, it is in professional life, or it is in our social life. Therefore, learning communication is very important for everyday operations. So to know communications, we have divided this communication basic, communication process, communication principles, communication skills into 30 different chapters. Starting from introduction, human communication, communication basics, communication barrier, communication process, communication approach, elements of communication, paraverbal communication, verbal communication, attitudes, mass media and social media communication, written communication, body language, perspective in communications, elements of communication, communication system, learning, active listening, effective written communication, mastering in art of conversation, conversation in psychology, advanced communication skills, building rapport, communication for career advancement, to develop communication skills, advanced communication skills for leaders, and dealing with different difficult people and situation. So these 30 chapters will be covered up through this discussion. Let's start with the first one, the introduction. In the introduction, we are going to discuss what is communication. I mean the definition of communication, the importance of communications, communication process, and communication skills. So let's start with what is communication. The word communication derived from a Latin word that is communicare. Communicare means to share, to make common. Communication is defined as the process of understanding and sharing meaning. In other words, we can term communication is simply the act of transferring information from one place, person, or group to another. Every communication involves one sender, a message, as well as a receiver. That means communication is a two-way process. If you say something, but your recipient, don't understand it, that communication is failed. Similarly, if you throw a message, but your audience or your receiver cannot decode it as per you, what you want to say, then it is also failed. Therefore, communication is the process of sending and receiving messages through verbal, non-verbal, and written, oral, or body language. So communication is the creation and exchange of meaning. Actually, we start communication from very beginning during a child, a kid, stay in the oval of his mother. At that period, he sends some signals, and then the mother can understand what the baby is like to communicate with. Similarly, after taking birth, we communicate with our surroundings and we share our feelings through nonverbal communication. Afterwards, human beings started social communication, family communications. Then during educational period, he started to communicate with teachers, fellow students, and others. So thus, we communicate until our death. Therefore, it is very important to understand, to acquire the communication skills as per required. For example, why communication skill is important? Communication skills is important to solve problem. For example, you work in an organization, in a company, but your fellow colleagues and many other people, many other stakeholders has to be dealt with. But due to lack of communication, there may be miscommunication, lack of information, and thus problem could be arises. So to solve a problem, we have to have communicate first, because for problem solution purpose, we have to understand why this problem has been occurred and who are responsible for this problem, how we can solve the problem. So to solve a problem, communication is must. Second one is strong decision making. Before taking decision regarding anything, we must understand the basics of the issue and current status of the issue, what would be the future impact. So we have to communicate with the relevant stakeholders to understand the situation and take a decision regarding it. More productivity. In a factory where different class of workers, officials, and stakeholders are involved with, if we can convey the motive of the company, the aim of the factory, and then we can keep everyone in the same pace. While everyone stay in the same pace, the productivity must be increases. Therefore, communication is very important to increase productivity. Consistency in the workflow. Similarly, if everybody is satisfied in a factory, in a company, in an organization, then they will maintain their space of work. Thus, they will maintain the consistency. Strong business relations. One company have to deal with its supplier, its workers, its employees, relevant government officials, much more stakeholders. If anything is missing or due to lack of communication, any stakeholder may just react negative. Therefore, communications, effective communication can establish a stronger bondage, a stronger relationship with the stakeholders. And effective communication helps us to maintain better control over the situation, as well as establishing professional image. Communication is very important for branding, for marketing, for maintaining social classes. Everywhere, effective communications is important. Better response from the stakeholders. If you can communicate your motives, your aim, your objective with your customers, your audience, as a business person, then as a officials, as a manager, as a managing director, then your every stakeholder will cooperate with you and you will meet the success. So communication is very important in our professional life. Similarly, it is important also in our family life. If you cannot convince your partner, your kids, your children, your father, your mom in the family about your motive, then someone may misunderstand you. But if you communicate your personality, your aim, objective with them, everybody will cooperate with you to reach your success. Thus, effective communication is also important in our family life. Let's start with the communication process. In the communication process, we find a sender, a communicator. an initiator. He encode the message what he would like to throw for the receiver or audience, and after encoding, he select a channel. In which channel he could, whether it could be a face-to-face communication, whether he can say it's over phone, whether he can send an email or write a letter. So sender select the channel, and after selecting the channel, he transmit the message through the selected channel. While it reach to the receiver or recipient or the objective, then the receiver decode the message according to his background, his cultural ability, his educational background, his mentality. Then receiver understand the message and give a feedback. But by this time, many types of noises may be occurred. Maybe technical noises, maybe